and staying safe at home, and you're all making the most of all of your time.
Thank you so much to Dance Lines for asking us to do these workshops for you. I'll be bringing you a freestyle workshop, and Kirsty is going to be doing the slow dance. We would recommend going outside if possible with these, just to get a bit more space, but do adapt these to wherever room you've got inside. Just enjoy, and hope you enjoy the dancing.
We've got the boys here today demonstrating some of the sections for you, because they will demo them a little bit better than we will. So use them as your guide, but just do it to your level in your space, as Adam said. Have cool. fun, guys.
Have fun.
Hello guys, I hope you're all doing really good today. Today we are doing a slow routine to a song by Alicia Keys called Good Job. If you've not heard it before, it's a really, really lovely song. And yeah, so we're gonna do a little routine to it today. I've got some dancers here to help me demonstrate some things. The routine is set on a left leg kicking and a left leg turning. But if you do the other way, just mirror or just do whatever is comfortable for you. It's not a problem, just have fun and hopefully you enjoy it. So we're gonna start facing the back with your hands just loose by your side. And your left leg slightly behind, because you're going to step on that one first, okay? We're going to step left leg, then right leg, with your arms circling forwards over your body. And as you step into the last move, you want to pull your chest down towards your knee. So you want to go step, hop, and circle these arms back. As you do, you plie, your body comes down here, okay? So you're going to turn your feet out, your chest is going to come down. Try and let your head drop last. So you're going to go back, one, two, drop, three, four. From here, you're going to turn your right leg in over your left shoulder. You're going to shoot your arms up, both arms up high. Hands nice and stretched. And from there, you're going to bring them down behind your neck. As you do, you want to just transfer your weight from side to side as your head goes back. Okay, so we start facing the back. We go hop, go one, two, up, three, four, back, five, six, seven, eight. Okay? Eight. Okay? So from the beginning, we step, we go back one, two, three, four, back five, six, seven, eight in. As you bring your legs in, you're gonna cross your arm, your right arm over to your shoulder, right, left, and you're gonna drop your hands down, swap. As you drop your hands down, you wanna swap your legs over, just lift your heel on the other foot. So from your back head backwards, we go step with this leg in, we're going to go cross, cross, you're going to drop your hands down from your shoulders, just nice loose hands, and just try and show the forearm to the front. If you can, put your ear down towards the side. So if you're going to use your left leg on this next move, if that's your confident leg, put your left ear towards the floor, so you're here. If you're going to use your right, just do the other one, that's fine. Okay, so we go from the beginning, five, six, seven, eight, hop, one, two, up, three, four, back, five, six, seven, eight, one. Drop, two, and up. Okay? From there, we're gonna bring our leg, whichever leg you want to, up into a front catch, but you're gonna bring it up slowly up as close to your body as you can. So you're gonna pull it up from your ankle as high as you can, two, three, four. From there, you're gonna slowly release the leg and your arms are gonna come away from your body as your leg pulls out to the side. So Michael will show you a little bit better than I will. From there, you do the little release. You're gonna release to the side. If you're doing your right leg, just release to the other side. You wanna try and bend the bottom leg as the top leg comes out slowly and controlled, okay? From there, you're gonna step onto that leg. We're gonna turn across our body to face the back and just re-step into a plie. So if your leg was up, if you were left leg or right leg, if you're mirroring, leg two, three, four, it's gonna release out. You're gonna step onto it, cross over and re-step into a plie on that same leg, okay? With that, there is some arms, so we'll just go for that a little bit there because that's the end of section one. So we go from the leg up, two, three, four. You're gonna release, step onto it. You're gonna cross open. As you step out to the plie, your arms are gonna circle over with the flexed hands, and you're gonna push over this, my left leg, if you're doing right, that's fine. Push over to the side, okay? From there, you're gonna do a pull with your right hand across your chest, and it's gonna pull arms so your shoulder comes up and then push back the way you came. Okay, so to the front, I'll just show you the arm. So it will go from your push down, this arm is gonna pull across your body, it's gonna pull up and then push back down. You wanna try and go up and under if you can with your chest, just to get the movement around through your legs. Don't move your feet, just transfer your weight through each leg. Okay, so after that leg hold here, we go up, go one, two, three, four, release. six, seven. Step, circle, plie, two, three. You're gonna pull with that arm, one, two. From here, you're gonna stay in the plie. You're gonna high release to my right, to your left maybe. You're gonna go over to the side. Arms are gonna come out, elbows pulling down. And you wanna lean away from the side. So from the side that your arms are, you wanna lean away. So it'll just go from the leg hold, we'll try the little footstep counts for that. So we go leg one, two, three, four, release, five, six, seven, eight, go one, two, three, four, and five, six, seven, eight.
You're the engine that makes all things go, and you're always in disguise, my hero. I see your light in the dark, smile in my face when we all know it's hard.
Okay, good guys, well done. We're gonna move on to part two now, okay? This bit is turning to the left. Like I said, if you spin right or if you are more comfortable going right, you can just mirror it. That's not a problem. Just give it a go, that's absolutely fine. We're gonna start at where we've just finished. So we're facing the back, just with our arms pulled out to the right, elbows down, hands nice and soft. You're gonna step over your left shoulder and we're gonna just do an inwards turn with a straight leg. Well, the right leg is going to be straight. We're going to use onto the left leg, and you want to pull your arms out into like a little bit of another high release. Your head can go back or can stay up, whichever one you're more comfortable with. So from here, you're going to pull in onto the left side. You're going to pull these arms back as you turn. One full turn. From here, you want to bring your right leg out to the bottom diagonal. From there, we're going to go into a backwards attitude turn on your right leg, so your left leg is going to be up. Your hands are gonna pull in to your hip bones here and make sure they're nice and stretched. So it will go from the high release here. You're gonna go inwards turn to the left. Step this right foot down, backwards attitude to the right. So you're gonna go back this way. And you're gonna step out that leg in front. Step right leg, and then the left leg is gonna come up to the side. So it will go from there. It will go round, sorry, inside left, step backwards right, step out, step together, step left. Okay, so it's just down to this diagonal here. Again, if you're mirroring and the directions are a little bit tricky, just try and copy off the camera. So from here, as you step out, your right arm is gonna pull up and under and your body's gonna kind of do a little bit of a snake motion to the side. You wanna watch your hand, so it's gonna go side. As it comes in, you're gonna push in with your chest. Your left arm is just kind of mimicking this other leg here, so it's gonna go to the side. So you'll go from your turn, 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 step, step, out, push. Good. From here, you're gonna lift your left leg. This can be as high as you want or a low one, it's not a problem here. But your left leg is gonna do a little circle motion up and out, and you wanna extend it right the way out to the side to step onto it in a second. Your arms, the left arm is gonna push forwards and then away. The right arm is gonna come over and to the side. And I want your head to go over to the side to follow your right arm. So however high you want to get it, it could just be in front, that's not a problem. If you can get it high and your left leg is your confident leg, go for it up nice and high and then release out. So from, you've just come under snake, push, you're gonna lift straight up, one and around. You're gonna step onto this left leg and you're gonna do a full ponche turn on your left with your arms out. I won't show you, but it'll be on the screen. So you're gonna turn around to the side, two, three. We're gonna slide the right leg, so don't put it down. It's gonna slide on the floor in front of you, on the side of your leg, and you're gonna roll over onto your hips. Okay, if you're outside, please be careful on sliding on whatever ground you're on. Make sure it is safe to slide, and carpet, don't slide on there. But if you can, you're trying to get your left leg, ponche turn around, so your right leg is in the air, around, around, around. The right leg is then gonna come straight through. You're gonna roll from here, sitting on this left, right hip, sorry. Hips around, bend your knees in, and just come up to face the back, okay? So we'll just recap from the start of part two. There is just one more move in this part, and then we'll see it to some music and piece it together. So we've gone high release. We're gonna go step inwards, turn to the left, back, back, back. Step onto the right to the diagonal. We're gonna pull in backwards attitude, same way to the left, but just with your right leg. Step out, step together. Step side, you're gonna use your right arm to snake up and push. From here, your left leg is gonna come up and over. It's gonna circle, push, and around. Step onto it to the left. Ponche turn around, around, around. Right leg is gonna slide out here onto your hip, bend your knees into your bottom, sit onto your knees to the back. Good. From here, this part is the left leg. If you do right leg, you can still do the turn to the left, slide out onto your knees around, and you'll just have to do an extra turn into the kick, okay? It's just a kick behind your head. You want to be on your hip, on your knee, sorry, pushing your hips up high. The leg is going to kick behind your head and come down slowly here. So again, I won't show you, but Michael will. From here, you want to sit onto your hands. Your leg is going to come up here and down, release back down to this position. Then you're going to bring the leg back up, grabbing hold of the outside of your calf. It's going to shoot up to the ceiling or the sky, and head back and hold there. So that is part two. We will put it all together quickly now from the beginning. So part one and part two. We will see part two to music and then we will move on. And let's go from there. So we go facing the back. Wait for the music. We go hop one, two, shoot three, four, back five, six, seven, eight, drop down. Ear down to the floor if you can. So your chest wants to be low here. Hands kind of relaxed. Your leg is going to come up from the floor. Pull up. Two, three, four, release. Six, seven, step onto it, face the back. You go push. We're gonna use the right arm to pull across. In, we're gonna release up to the side. Good. Turn back over the shoulder. Shoulder one, two, back attitude to right diagonal. Back, step. We're gonna step our legs together. You're gonna snake out this arm, side, push. Left leg is gonna come up and around. Step side, punch your turn to left. Slide through, round to knees, kick up, slow, and head. Good. On that kick on the floor, look the direction that your leg has come. So as it kicks up, you want to look there and then forward. Yeah, and the leg wants to come right behind your head. Good. Really good. Right, let's have a look, a little go to some music, see if we can get the timing, and then we'll go for part three.
My face when we all know it's hard. There's no way to ever pay you back. Bless your heart, no, I love you for that. Honest and selfless, I don't know if this helps.
Good guys, right, we're on to part three. So we're starting on the floor. You've just done your leg up on your right or left leg, whichever one is best for you. So you're on your knees, the leg is up in the sky. From here, okay, this move, depending on which leg you're gonna do, you're still gonna go the same direction, you're just gonna swap your leg. So you're gonna roll over, I'll do it on your left leg first, over towards the front, hands on the floor in like a push-up position. Your leg wants to come right over the top, nice and straight as far as you can get it. If you can arch your back, keep your head up as well to get that nice straight line shape here, okay? So from that position there, you're gonna crawl over, leg is gonna shoot straight up nice to the front. Okay, good. This bit is quite tricky. We've got a slow motion video of Micah just doing it just so you can see the arms. But from this position here with that one leg in the air, depending on which leg you are doing, will determine which way you're gonna turn. But your arms are gonna windmill over the top like this. If you're going with your left leg split, you wanna go over your left leg shoulder. If you're going with your right leg split, you wanna go over your right shoulder. So, hands are gonna be on the floor, the leg is gonna be right up over as high as it can go. We're gonna go from here, you're gonna lift your hands off the floor, you're gonna turn on your leg that is behind you. The other leg is gonna retire in and just come in to your body. Your arms are gonna windmill over and you're gonna end back in that same position on the floor. As far back as you can, with your back arch and your leg nice and straight. The aim you want to get is to try and keep your head at the front the whole time. So from that stretch up and the whoosh around, you want to keep your head to the front the whole time. Okay, so don't come up too high to go into that move. So from that move there, you'll be your leg nice and extended in front. You're going to collapse down. So if you're on your left leg, you're going to collapse down to your left side and pull in. So you're just facing the side here, just the right side. Good. From here, you're going to push your hips up. Your hands are going to go into the back of your head, well, the side of your head. Hand fingers on the back. You're gonna arch your back as far as you can, but keeping your hips up so you don't hit your head. Back from here, you're gonna do a body roll from the arch position. Head first, arms first, and pull in. Okay, so you're gonna go all the way back and then roll all the way up. From here, We're going to shoot your left leg out to the front. Your arms are going to do another little kind of roll to the front. Your arms are going to come up in an L shape. So your right arm is going to go back. The left arm is going to go forwards. You're going to return back to this position here. And you're going to do a toe rise straight from here. I want no prep, so I just want it to go from here down to push straight up. So just be careful on your ankles where you're pushing up if you're outside and it's uneven. You want to push straight up into your toe rise. Okay? Good. Right, let's just go back from the floor from that little whoosh bit and we'll go over some of the timing on the counts because it is to some of the words, but just do your best. So we are down here. This is the chorus. So leg is up. We roll when she says good job. So we go round, good job. Leg, hands up, little whoosh around, back down, collapse in. Two, three, hands and head go back and roll. This is don't get you down. So your arms are gonna push in, back into that small position here. You're gonna toe rise on the first matter. So she says matter three times. The first one is the toe rise. Okay, so we go toe rise, one, two. From here, you're gonna step your left leg to the front, you're going to hop onto it and you're going to swipe your left arm in front and you're going to hop onto it so that your right arm comes in like a contraction and your back leg's pulled into your knee, just turned out. So from the toe rise, land straight on the spot, try not to stumble backwards. So toe rise, land, hop, pull in. From here, you're going to step back on the right leg. Your left leg is going to come up into a box kick hold. You're going to hold the outside of just above your knee. Your other arm is going to pull to get your face back to the front. The leg wants to come up as high as possible and hold it up as straight as you can for as long as you can. Okay, so that's the third matter. So it goes one, two, three. Yeah, and you wanna end just facing the front, just back in second position because we're gonna hop to the side in a second. Okay, so we'll go back from the beginning, just of that part there, and then I'll piece through from the beginning, and then we will try that bit to the music. So we go back from the floor, hands, leg is up, holding. We go round, hands down, leg up. Two, three, four, little whoosh, and round, and collapse. Two, three, in, go back, and roll. Hands go up, eyes to the front, drop, toe rise up, and land. Hop to the front. Swing around the back with the leg up, up, and step. Good. Right, we'll see that's the music. Just do your best. We will do part four, and then we'll just go with some of the word accents of where you want to get some of the music.
But good job. You're doing a good job, a good job. You're doing a good job. Don't get too down. The world needs you now. Know that you matter.
Okay, good. So part four is the shortest part. Just come round with your box kick around, landing to the front. We're going to do a chasse to the left side here. Again, if you're right leg, you could go to the right. It doesn't really matter too much. You're at home, it's fine. You're going to chasse with your arms just out, just one hop. So just the one step, close these legs. We're going to go into a turning split dive round, we would call them, or jeté round, whatever you guys call them. Your arms are going to shoot up to the ceiling on the first one, and the second one, they're going to shoot away into this half position here. So if you're going to the left, you're going to shoot your right arm straight and your left arm into your shoulder and you're going to look away to the left. If you're doing right, you would just do the other way and obviously look the other way. So you're going to go. For the footwork. After your second dive, so your legs come up, you should be landing on the left leg first. You're gonna tuck the right knee in to bend to face the back. You're gonna roll over on your bottom and extend the left leg here. If you've extended the left leg, you should have your left arm on the floor planted. And you're gonna just do like a kick around to the side, just on this left shoulder. So if you are not quite as strong in your acro, just stand up or you can just roll around to the side. It's not a problem. If you can, you wanna do a kick over, like Michael will show you in a second, up to standing. Okay, so we'll just go from that bit there. You're gonna go hop one, two, plie through, arms go split dive one, split dive two, roll around. Leg comes up and over, finish face the front. from here, it's just a little turn section. You can do what we do, or you can do your own turns. It's not a problem. So this is just your part here to do whatever turns you want to do at the end. But we are going to do, Mike is going to show you just a little turning combination that we do. So we're going to step into a backwards pirouette on your left direction, so on your right foot. You're going to step and prepare just in this L shape. You're going to lift your left leg into a retiro and pirouette, just normally hands in here. As you come around, after you've done the double, this left leg is going to just bend and drop to the floor. You don't use your hands, so you go spin, spin, drop. As it drops, your left hand wants to go down to the floor. Your right arm is going to circle over as the right leg shoots over, and then you're going to collapse it back in. Put your head back as well when the arm goes back, so it pulls in here. Okay, so it should continue from the turn. If you do right leg, it would just be the opposite. So you would just use your opposite arm to circle. Okay, the arm is going backwards and then contracting in. So it would go from your dive round, you want to step out on your right leg, pirouette one, two, bend it straight down. Her left hand's going to go on the floor. You're going to shoot the arm one, two. From here, we've just done a little kick and roll. So we're going to come over onto our right knee. This left leg is going to come up. You're going to throw your arms up. Left leg's going to get as high as it can go and just roll out of it. Okay. And that is the end there, guys. So if you have any sort of turns you want to do at the end, that's fine. Use as much of the music as you can and just enjoy that last little bit. So that is really whatever you want to do. If you want to do the turn section that we're doing at the end, that's fine. If you want to do one of your own, that's fine too. So we'll just go from part four, which is just after you've done your box kick around, land to the front. So we're going to go hop one, step, split dive round one, split dive round two. You're going to roll out of that split dive. Left leg is going to come over the top in a split and stand up. Step into your turn. So you're going to step one, two, three. We're going to go round up, drop, knee down, throw the leg up and roll. Okay?
Yeah. You're doing a good job. You're doing a good job. Don't get too down.
Good. Right, that is the whole routine, guys. So we, I'm going to mark it from the beginning and just try and get some of the accents, because some of the parts are on certain words, which will help you with the timing. Obviously, it's up to you guys where you want to go with it. So if you want to go a little bit faster, a little bit slower, just do what you want to do best. That's fine, as long as you're having fun and enjoying it. So we'll go back from the beginning, and I'll just mark where I have put moves to the words. But don't worry too much if you haven't got them. That's fine. So we go set one, two, three, four, five, six. Now the first word, like checkpoint, is hero, and that is when the part where you shoot these arms down. Remember, you're swapping your legs here. This is hero here, where your ear is down. Okay, from there the leg comes up, two, three, we go round, step, two, here, side, two. This one is hard. So as these arms go back, that's where she says hard. Okay, you'll understand when the music comes on. From here we step side, round one, two, back attitude, three, four, step and side, in, leg, round, poncho turns to the left, one, two, you slide out on the right leg, round, roll these legs, this is to the back if you're doing your left leg, back kick, in, hold head. From here, this is the chorus, so she says good job, hands go leg, leg comes up, two, three, four, whoosh, one, two, good job again, we go collapse, and back. As you're just finishing this, she says the word down, it comes up here. This is the three matters. Says know that you matter, matter, leg matter, yeah. And then we go shoot up, two, split dive one, split dive two, roll out, leg up to stand. From here we go step into your turns. So step one, two, go three, four, step, leg and a roll. Good. Right, well, we'll see Mike all the way through. Like I said, there was the little words of the checkpoints, but if you don't get them, it's fine. Just enjoy it. I hope you have lots of fun. I hope you enjoyed it, and yeah, keep well, guys.
You're the engine that makes all things go, and you're always in disguise, my hero. I see your light in the dark, smile in my face when we all know it's hard. There's no way to ever pay you back. Bless your heart, no, I love you for that. honest and selfless. I don't know if this helps it, but good job. You're doing a good job, a good job. You're doing a good job, don't get too down. The world needs you now. Know that you matter, 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 yeah. You're doing a good job, a good job. You're doing a good job, don't get too down.
So we hope you enjoyed the workshop today, guys, and took something away from it.
Like we say, you can watch back over this video as many times as you want, rewind it, and just enjoy yourself, guys, yeah? Get outside, just enjoy dancing for the love of dancing while we're at home, and fingers crossed, we'll be back to normal soon, guys. But thank you so much, again, Dance Lines, for letting us do this, and have a great day, guys!